this image slider, it is not auto completing. So in order to make some auto movement into this slider, we need to implement some added code into it. And in that essence, we need to get back to index.html. And here we will be implementing some kind of function which has been created by us. So how to do it? We will be using our own function over here. For say we are using this function of autoplay. Writing it. Now we have invoked this custom function here, which is known as autoplay. So we need to define them. That is why we will be now we are providing here this autoplay option, so we need to define it. Another thing, we have not provided this class name over here. It is practically indicating the class name. We have missed this class name here. So that is why it wasn't working. So if we now get back to our project and reload, we will see that this is the result. Practically, there is no such interval over here. We haven't mentioned what should be the time interval. So that is why this eerie output right over here, those are practically maintaining no schedule of interval between two consecutive sliders. So this is what we need to mention here. So we are putting for say this time interval of 2 seconds. So that's why we need to put this parameter of milliseconds here. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. And now we can see that there is a sharpened time interval of 2 seconds. In the same manner, if we now increase it a little for say the slider interval will be 5 seconds, so we need to set this parameter accordingly. Get back to your project and reload. And now we can see that the autoplay option is initiating 5 seconds after it. So this is how we are now able to create our own carousel slider into our project. And in the next case, we will be learning about implementing this maneuver right over here. And then our target will be to put this maneuver into the position right on the top of this carousel slider that we have created into our project. And another thing, in the last case, I would like to suggest you to remove all those background colors. And if you do not wish to keep any more padding at the beneath of this carousel slider, then remove them all. All you need to do, get back to stylesheet.css and look for those padding bottom options, those we have turned on over here, in an order to see the result, whether they are exactly working or not. And if you do not wish to keep all those padding things, then you need to remove this padding, and you need to remove this background too, if you do not wish to put any kind of background color into the carousel slider or into this individual slider holder right over here.